you gotta wow, you gotta impress on Valentine's Day with the flowers, but with some great hacks from one of the best florists on the planet. Don't take my word for it. Ask three presidents. It's been three?
It's four? It's on my fourth now. On her, 2 weeks.
Look at that. She's got a fourth president. Heather Cooper, we are in her home in historic Occoquan. And how are we going to make these flowers look amazing that you got at the grocery store?
Absolutely. So you pick up some flowers at the grocery store. They always come looking a little bit sad in their wrapper. We want to make this really fun.
They've been hanging out reading the tabloids the whole time. That's
exactly.
Why.
They're like poor things and not getting paid attention, smothered in plastic. Either way, first thing you're going to do with any of the flowers you get is you're going to strip them. Take all of these little leaves off. I've done that for quite a few of these, so you don't need to worry. The tulips so far are okay, but tulips tend to have wilted stems, so you want to take off any of these leaves that don't look right, and you can keep a few on there.
All the way, even on the roses, little
couple
leaves?
Even on all the roses, take them all off, because those leaves actually take away from the flower. They suck up water that should be going to the bloom, and then the bloom wilts a little bit faster if you leave
those on. I've always said that.
And they also can decay in water. So if you have a clear vase, you don't want leaves down in the water because they slowly decay, and that pollutes the water, and the flower drinks it, and it doesn't live as long. So
how many bunches of flowers should you get from a grocery store to make something look beautiful?
I would say you probably want to do about four.
Okay.
Four bunches of them, unless you find a gargantuan type of size. We're going to start with something fun. So I found this cute vase. This is a lady, the head of a lady. It's like a Roman goddess.
Little face vase.
I love the face vase, and I also love a not clear vase, specifically because you won't see the stems, you won't see the water as it absorbs the color of the stem, so it starts to get murky and whatnot, which is normal. I have used floral foam. You can find this at your local craft stores. It's not styrofoam, so really look in the floral
different
section.
Things, yes.
Much different section. You soak it in water, so it's really solid with water.
Okay,
so
how long do you soak
soft.
It for?
It doesn't take long. This is pretty instant now. You know, a couple minutes. Don't push it in the water. Let it slowly sink in. It'll fill up, and now we have a great base to start with. We're gonna start with some fun lilies, and lilies are always great because you can get bits of them, and you can start putting them in, and as you can see, hold the stem nice and low.
And you can just jab it in there.
You just jab it into this foam, which is great. You want to make sure your flower arrangement is probably about 1.5 times bigger than the vase it's under. So if you keep it too small, it's just not going to look right. And if you go too crazy, you're going to need a whole heck of a lot more flowers.
Isn't she lovely? Look at this.
So all I did was use those small stems. I cut the top of the flower off, and then I just inserted them in groups. So as you can see, I have the red, I have the pink, I have the lily to the side, and then the tulips in the back.
These tulips will bloom later too, which is kind of cool. You have like a few days of stuff going on here.
Yep, they will open up quite nicely, which is great. You always leave a little bit of a hole where you insert the foam to be able to water it as you go, but that foam holds a lot of water. So you'll still get a good light, and it has preservatives in it as well, and usually a little bit of floral food in the foam.
Very nice. Heather Cooper, always being creative. Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day to you.
Isn't she beautiful? Look at that.